You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to BorisFX.com for the premium download.
There are a lot of these tufts in the middle top of the head here. Let's go out of the stabilize mode to none. We'll zoom out and we'll just close our layers and lock them. Okay, so I'm looking at the top of the head and it has all these little hair tufts that come up. So we'll just work on one of these areas up here. So I'm going to choose this part here. I'm going to make a new layer and make my shape. I'm going to try to include some of this fine hair at the top and at the base. Okay, and then we will track. Also, I should let you know that I am speeding up the tracking in the video so we save some time in the class. Okay, the tracking's done, and I'm going to call this layer top, middle, tuft, core. And we'll go into the stabilize view and take a look at that. Okay, it looks pretty good. So now I can put some shapes in there, but first I'm going to just make a core shape for this layer, and then we'll make the fine hairs later. So I'm going to just label this track. Change the color. Sometimes I forget, but I'll do that now. And then I'm going to put in a core shape. So I want my core shape, I'll go to the reshape mode, not just to be like a round or a square shape. I'm going to actually make some indentations so that I can add the fine hairs a little more easily. I'm going to go to a frame where it's pretty clear. This looks good, and start making my shape. So my shape's going to have some little spikes in it. I can even change the tension, which is a good thing to do if you want it to give the hair a little more of a spiky quality on the inside and the out. So I'll just hold down the Alt key and change the tension. I sort of do this at the tops and at the bottom, but I leave the in-between points the normal B-spline tension. So it's a little quick here, but that's the general idea. And then if I play it through, it's sticking pretty well. So then I can duplicate this shape or this layer, Command D. And I'll lock my core layer and I'll call this Tuft Detail Open Shapes, because I can make my open shapes now and then set the width later. I'll delete the core shape. We don't need that. And I can drop in some hairs. They are a little hard to see because it's a little bit blurry. But we'll give this a try. And in my final, I have a lot more hairs, but we don't have time to roto all the hair in this class. So we'll just start with a few. So then you can see that they're sticking pretty well. And then if something moves, we can try to move them as a group. So sometimes it's like rotoing grass. It's like blades of hair, just like grass. So if something, the wind blows and you want to just maybe move only the tips of the points or the tips of the strands, you can use an alternate selection method. We'll do that this way. So we have all our shapes selected, but we just want to select the group at the top. Instead of using the square selection tool, I can actually use the freehand point selection. So my default is the rectangular selection, but if I want freehand, I can just hold down the control command key and just draw my lasso or freehand tool around the points, and then I can rotate them, go into the T for transform. I'm in the points mode. Click W to rotate, and we just do a slight rotation. So it's sort of a micro movement, but it does make a big difference. All right, before we move on to look at the final nodes, let's go down and look at the upper body.